Welcome to Implementing Hybrid Scenarios with Office 365 and SharePoint Server 2013. This is Module 1, Business Drivers and Considerations.
The content provided in these modules is intended for organizations who are currently using SharePoint Server 2013 on-premises, have evaluated the benefits and capabilities of SharePoint Online, and are interested in a hybrid solution, and would like to learn more about the considerations necessary when planning a hybrid deployment. Cloud computing has become a popular and successful computing model that enables organizations to reduce both their capital and operational expenditures, renew IT innovation, and gain the advantage of more rapid software delivery to meet their business needs. However, according to a recent Forrester study, only 8% plan a full deployment in the Office 365 cloud, but an additional 26% will move to a hybrid cloud on-premises deployment. A hybrid environment that uses SharePoint Server 2013 and SharePoint Online enables solutions that integrate functionality between services and features such as Search, Microsoft Business Connectivity Services, and Duet Enterprise Online for Microsoft SharePoint and SAP in both environments. This module provides the business value and rationale for a hybrid deployment using SharePoint Server 2013 and SharePoint Online. The Business Drivers and Considerations module provides an overview of the primary factors and resources that drive hybrid deployment scenarios and subsequent considerations when considering and/or implementing a hybrid deployment when leveraging Office 365 and SharePoint 2013. With SharePoint Server 2013 Hybrid, productivity services and SharePoint Online can be securely integrated with on-premises SharePoint Server 2013 to provide unified functionality and access to data. For enterprises who want to gradually move their existing on-premises SharePoint Server 2013 services to the cloud, SharePoint Server 2013 Hybrid provides a staged migration path by extending high-impact SharePoint Server 2013 workloads to SharePoint Online. A SharePoint Server 2013 Hybrid environment enables identity management and trusted communications between SharePoint Online and SharePoint Server 2013. When you have established this trust framework, you can configure integrated functionality between services and features such as Search, Microsoft Business Connectivity Services, and Duet Enterprise Online for Microsoft SharePoint and SAP. Implementing hybrid scenarios with Office 365 and SharePoint Server 2013 provides a roadmap for exploring, planning, installing, and configuring SharePoint Server 2013 and SharePoint Online hybrid deployments. Your business requires a flexible IT infrastructure that can scale on demand. With a private cloud in your data center, you can be more agile and manage resources more effectively. When you extend your data center to meet the public cloud, you are working in a hybrid cloud model. A hybrid cloud gives you the best of both worlds, so you can take advantage of external resources when it makes sense for your business. The SharePoint Hybrid Cloud combines Windows Azure, SharePoint Server 2013, and Office 365, giving you Microsoft's enterprise-grade technology in both your company's own data center and Microsoft global data centers. Extending into the cloud should expand your options without adding complexity. A Microsoft Hybrid Cloud lets you easily move workloads from your data center to Office 365 or a hosting service provider's data center while still maintaining a complete view of the infrastructure. You can build hybrid applications that leverage both on-premises and cloud resources, and you can take advantage of storage, backup, and recovery options with increased efficiency and reduced cost. The benefits of a hybrid environment include the ability to maintain consistency across clouds with familiar tools and resources, extending your own data center with consistent management tool set and a familiar development and identity solution, enterprise-grade performance and security in the data center and in the cloud, meeting changing business needs with greater flexibility, and delivering capacity on demand. Prior to deploying a hybrid environment with SharePoint Server 2013 and Office 365, you should have a basic understanding of hybrid models. Even if your enterprise is already familiar with some or all of the technologies involved, there are many configuration details that must be followed precisely for the deployment to succeed. In this section, we'll introduce hybrid models. Hybrid cloud is a composition of two or more clouds, private, community, or public, that remain distinct entities but are bound together, offering the benefits of multiple deployment models. Hybrid cloud can mean the ability to connect colocation, managed and/or dedicated services with cloud resources. In the context of Office 365, hybrid cloud is characterized by workloads such as Exchange, SharePoint, or Link that are deployed in the cloud in coexistence with the same or any other workloads on-premises. For example, SharePoint Online with SharePoint on-premises and Exchange on-premises. There are two basic types of hybrid deployments. Hybrid within a workload, such as SharePoint Online and SharePoint Server side-by-side deployments, and hybrid between workloads, such as SharePoint Online working with Link Server enabling presence. A SharePoint hybrid deployment integrates features in SharePoint Online with your on-premises SharePoint Server 2013 system. By leveraging both systems and allowing access to both, companies can integrate their business services to create a hybrid SharePoint environment that enables secure access to applications and data from anywhere. A hybrid solution can let your company get started in the cloud, taking a small step first to explore cloud functionality on a small scale. Some companies prefer taking a slower approach and learning what works best for them. You can use hybrid SharePoint to provide access to collaboration features and content for team projects, extranet users, and remote divisions. Using hybrid SharePoint, you can migrate team projects to SharePoint Online while maintaining connectivity to SharePoint Server 2013 content and resources. A hybrid environment enables enterprise users to be connected anywhere to the resources and the content that they need. Cloud services such as SharePoint Online and Office 365 can be an attractive alternative to on-premises SharePoint business solutions. However, for a variety of reasons, you might want or need to deploy specific solutions in the cloud while maintaining your on-premises SharePoint Server 2013 farm. Some enterprises may wish to gradually move their existing on-premises SharePoint Server 2013 services to the cloud using a staged migration, in which SharePoint Server 2013 workloads are moved to SharePoint Online one at a time. Hybrid functionality in SharePoint Server 2013 and SharePoint Online in Office 365 enables you to extend your on-premises investment to the cloud by integrating services like SharePoint Search, Business Connectivity Services, and Duet Enterprise Online. Hybrid deployments can also be helpful when it's not possible for an organization to migrate to the cloud immediately or in full due to business, technical, or other reasons. Common scenarios of where hybrid environments can be useful include rapid provisioning of new workloads on Office 365 while maintaining existing on-premises workloads, organizations wishing to migrate workloads from an existing on-premises environment to the cloud over time in a phased approach, organizations wanting to supplement their cloud environment with additional features or customizations which are currently available only on-premises, or compliance or data sovereignty reasons, which might stipulate certain data be hosted in a particular location. This section in Module 1.1, Business Drivers and Considerations, provides a brief overview of hybrid deployment considerations. Hybrid environments can be helpful when it's not possible for an organization to migrate to the cloud immediately or in full due to business, technical, or other reasons, to include the availability of specific features related to one or more workloads in the cloud, a significant investment in on-premises customizations that cannot be ported to a supported app model, global network performance with users in low bandwidth situations, corporate and/or regulatory compliance that requires specific controls and safeguards that cannot be accommodated in the cloud, and lastly, manageability concerns that exist between on-premises and the cloud. For example, organizations with specific management needs based on business processes that are currently not exposed in SharePoint Online, processes dependent on scripting and/or automation where equivalent APIs are not exposed in SharePoint Online, investments in full trust code that cannot be ported to the cloud app model, and features currently not available in SharePoint Online. SharePoint 2013 is a versatile development platform for building apps and solutions with varying scopes that address a wide range of needs. Developers already familiar with SharePoint know that they can build server-side farm solutions that extend core SharePoint capabilities. SharePoint 2013 offers a new flexible development model. You can use SharePoint 2013 to create apps for SharePoint that take advantage of standard web technologies, such as JavaScript, OAuth, and OData. And SharePoint 2013 provides you with functionality to interact with SharePoint resources and a wide range of hosting options. The new app for SharePoint development model gives you the ability to build apps that take advantage of SharePoint capabilities and that run in the cloud instead of on your SharePoint farm. This flexible development model, along with the integration of standard web technologies, makes SharePoint development work more like other kinds of web development that you may already be doing. New apps for SharePoint are self-contained extensions that may include cloud-based logic and data, SharePoint components, and client-side scripts, but not custom managed code that runs on SharePoint servers. They can be installed either from the Office Store or an organizational app catalog, and can be installed on either on-premises farms or Microsoft SharePoint Online. SharePoint Farm Solutions are packages of SharePoint components that are uploaded to a farm-wide gallery from where they can be installed. They cannot be distributed through the Office Store, and they cannot be installed on SharePoint Online. They can include custom managed code that runs on the SharePoint Farm servers. Of the direct challenges addressed with the shift to the cloud are both compute and storage elasticity, as well as capital expense. A core benefit of hybrid environments is that design and patterns remain consistent, while there is a new emphasis on cost and latency. In an environment on-premises or in the cloud, latency becomes a concern when the information that must be served to a user or when a user submits content to a deployment exists in one or more states. The information must become aggregated across distributed systems, for example, hybrid search across SharePoint Server 2013 and SharePoint Online. The information is stored remotely and access is dependent on one or more transformations before presentation. The information exists outside of the firewall and must be remotely fetched. For pure cloud solutions, these may all be true. But in today's modern and distributed computing atmosphere, in most cases, information is already synchronized across cloud solutions and on-premises data stores. However defined, latency is largely a connectivity issue, where users, applications, and their related data are globally distributed. As such, the reliability and performance of those applications are affected. Milliseconds, no matter how small or measurable, can have a substantial impact on performance. When planning a hybrid environment, the network must be considered when evaluating performance, as it plays an important role in the success of your cloud deployment. When it comes to the hybrid cloud and latency, it must be location, location, location. Hybrid cloud governance must address policies related to security and compliance while keeping with the general IT goals and the overall strategic objectives of the enterprise. In some cases, corporate and/or regulatory compliance may preclude a wholesale migration to Office 365. In these scenarios, customers may elect to maintain an on-premises deployment for records management and archiving purposes, while in parallel leveraging SharePoint Online to support workloads such as social and OneDrive for Business. To make informed decisions and take full advantage of the potential benefits of adopting a hybrid model, IT architects and decision makers should weigh the business drivers and technical requirements against the economic, regulatory, political, and financial forces that are at work from both inside and outside of the company. Office 365 supports a number of compliance standards, to include the Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act, Data Processing Agreements, Federal Information Security Management Act, ISO 27001, European Union Model Clauses, US-EU Safe Harbor Framework, Family Educational Rights and Privacy Act, Statement on Standards for Attestation Engagements No. 16, Canadian Personal Information Protection and Electronics Document Act, and lastly, Graham Leach Bailey Act. The Directory Sync tool synchronizes with a single sign-on on-premises Active Directory Forest. If your organization has multiple forests for authentication and would like to use the Directory Sync tool, we highly recommend the following. Evaluate consolidating your forests. In general, there's more overhead required to maintain multiple forests. Unless your organization has security constraints that dictate the need for separate forests, consider simplifying your on-premises environment in advance of deploying the Directory Sync tool. Or use only your logon forest. Consider deploying Office 365 only in your primary logon forest for your initial rollout of Office 365. If you can't consolidate your multi-forest Active Directory deployment or using other directory services to manage identities, you may be able to synchronize these with the help of Microsoft or a partner. SharePoint Online provides several service applications that can be used to support related workloads, with several supported for use in hybrid topologies, to include search, business connectivity services, and Duet. However, additional workloads, while exposed in SharePoint Online, do not support a hybrid configuration, to include the user profile service, managed metadata service, and word automation services as examples. SharePoint Online requires minimal extra cost and overhead because there's no need to physically deploy any software on site, and because Microsoft assumes much of the operational burden of managing the IT infrastructure. As a cloud-based service, organizations simply subscribe to SharePoint Online. It's available in two versions, both offered through a flexible user subscription license that include access to either the entire Office 365 suite or to individual services. SharePoint Online is hosted in a multi-tenant environment on shared hardware in Microsoft data centers and is designed for companies of any size. SharePoint Online Dedicated is designed for companies with at least 5,000 users. It provides enterprise-scale features such as dedicated hosting and hardware, a fully customizable environment, and the ability to deploy full trust code. With either version, Microsoft handles the management of certain core IT infrastructure functions, including management of the server hardware, the Windows Server layer, and the SharePoint Online farm. Because SharePoint Online is hosted by Microsoft in redundant, geographically dispersed data centers, it benefits from the mission-critical availability and reliability. It's also governed by the same security policies and protocols that are used for vital enterprise applications. This section in Module 1.1, Business Drivers and Considerations, discusses the business drivers and considerations an organization must rationalize when choosing to deploy one or more hybrid scenarios. Module 2.1 next provides an overview of architecture, authentication, and provides a functional overview of hybrid scenarios.